Hello, everyone. It's Pika, welcome to my channel. We'll go through 5 mistakes to avoid in a group attack in this video. For these issues, we will also provide a solution or a correct strategy. Before I begin, I'd like to thank all of my supporters. Welcome back to my channel. So let's begin. The first mistake is in troop formation, which isn't doing anything to protect their heavy backline. This is a common issue in a lot of realms. Let's take a look at the latest Void Battle report. The troop formation is 4x4 here. Even mages constitute the majority of the backline. They are not protected by the frontline. We can see mages fighting one another at the 26th second. When there isn't a nearby target for the troops to hit, they will move. The mages moved down after eliminating frontline troops. Even mages experience the same thing. As a result, protecting your heavy backline is crucial. So, sending a 4x4 formation is inefficient. The odd archers in this spot don't do anything. It is recommended to use a 2x2 formation rather than a 4x4. Send odd cavalry and even infantry to the front lines. Send even or odd archers and odd mages to the back line. That is the most perfect solution. However, you can still make changes. This allows the back line to do more damage. The second mistake involves troop composition. The average statistics are decreasing. So, initially, we'll throw a few things to the test. We're sending 1,000 mages with a 0% attack value. We ended up with 296 kills. We increased the attack value to 15% on the second attempt. The final result was 326 kills. We got extra 30 kills. We then attempted a rally-based attack. We dispatch 500 troops from 2 castles to the first rally. One had a 15% mage attack, while the other had 0. Both castles got 155 kills. The number of kills reduced from 326 to 310. Castle with a 15% attack have a lower impact. The opposite castle, on the other hand, does greater damage. Attack value fell to 7.5% in total. We attempted to send only one lower tier troop to the next rally. We ended up with 326 kills. It makes no difference if you send one lower tier troop. Then we attempted to send 10% of lower tier troops. The final tally was 306 kills. The decline in percentage was 1.5%. So you can't allow your average metrics fall. Stop sending troops that aren't of the type you select. Send only cavalry and archer if you're a cavalry plus archer team. People send troops to balance, yet this really causes battles to be screwed up. Another example can be used to bring this to a conclusion. Castles A and B each deploy 100,000 troops. Castle A got a 150% attack bonus. Castle B got a 300% higher in attack value. The average then becomes 225%. The same may be said for defense, health, and damage. The third one is related to commanders. Poor decision-making abilities. Take a look at this report, 33 persons versus 1. Only 4 people sent level 12 troops, while the majority of people sent level 11 troops. Guy from Realm 1000 had 3.2 million level 13 troops. This is related to the previous statement. The average goes way down, but the defender's average value remains unchanged. When you play against just one individual, your chances of losing are high. You'll require troops as well as better stats. To equal him, you'll need at least 4 or 6 million level 12 troops. In this scenario, there are lots of examples. The fourth item on the list is not retreating battles. People claim that they are not scared to hit and so forth. That's a load of crap. Consider the following scenario. To check our chances, we have a status bar. The chance to win is gone at the 13th second. Around 615,000 troops were still alive at the 14th second. If they retreat, they may be able to save 100,000 plus troops. Always keep an eye on this bar. If it drops below 30%, it's time to pull back. You're not going to win in any case. They don't need to keep an eye on the ongoing battle. Two or three commanders should be prepared to give a retreat command. In the chat, they simply need to type R or something else. Timing is the last item on the list. In battles, people do not arrive on time. It's not good when people enter battles after 15 seconds. Battles are fought in real time. It has a great deal of impact if you join early. At the very least, people should be able to join the 5th or 6th second. When a battle might be over in less than 30 seconds. In this case, there's no sense in arriving after the 15th second. When the commander set the speed attack time. Attack march should be sent 3 or 5 seconds earlier. This will give us an extra 6 or 8 seconds to arrive to our place on time. If you're lagging a lot, it's recommended to avoid speed attacks. Before the attack, make a note of the time and speeds required. I believe that accelerating the march with a single tap will be more effective. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching, I'll be back next week with a new video.